Alleged seditious remarks by Philippine Congressman and former Speaker Pantaleon Alvarez. Lawmakers want him investigated for urging the military and police to abandon President Marcos Jr. Bianca Dava has tonight's top story.
The military and the police assured their full loyalty to the Constitution, shrugging off the call of Davao del Norte 1st District Representative Pantaleon Alvarez for the Armed Forces of the Philippines to withdraw its support for President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. In a political rally in Tagum City on Sunday night, Alvarez claimed such an act would allow the country to attain peace and stability.
Please withdraw your support to the chief executive. Pag po nag-withdraw kayo ng suporta sa kanya, ibig sabihin, sinusuportahan nyo ang provision sa saligang batas na to protect the people and the state. Yan po ang pinakamahalaga dyan. Pag po nag-withdraw kayo ng suporta sa kanya, wala na siyang ibang magagawa kundi bababa sa pwesto niya.
Alvarez made the call after noting the rising tensions between Manila and Beijing in the West Philippine Sea. He reminded the AFP of its duty to protect the people and the state.
Basahin niyo yung saligang batas. Ako pa ulit-ulit kong binasa yan. Wala akong makita na nakalagay sa saligang batas na sinasabi, the armed forces of the Philippines shall protect the Commander-in-Chief. Ang nakalagay sa saligang batas ganito, the armed forces of the Philippines shall protect the people and the state. Pag sumabog ang gulo sa West Philippine Sea, there will be countless of dead bodies. There will be unimaginable destruction, famine, hunger. Mangyayari po yan.
The AFP reiterated its strict adherence to the chain of command where the president serves as the commander-in-chief. The military also assured the public that it remains dedicated to its mandate regardless of individuals in authority.
The AFP reiterates our unwavering commitment to professionalism, loyalty, and of course to the Constitution, and our strict adherence to the chain of command. Our soldiers, our pilots, and our sailors and Marines remain dedicated to our mandate of safeguarding the sovereignty and territorial integrity of the Philippines, regardless of any political affiliations and or individuals in authority. Our duty is to protect the Filipino people and to uphold the rule of law, ensuring that peace and development will prevail throughout the nation. We will continue to fulfill these responsibilities with integrity, impartiality, and utmost dedication.
The Philippine National Police said, while it respects freedom of expression, it does not want to be caught in the middle of these political statements.
Nakapatan po silang magsalita po ng kanilang mga damdamin po at yan naman po ay po Biden under our laws po na magsalita po sila. But however, on the part of the PNP po, remain loyal to the Constitution at ang ating pong loyalty ay nasa ating mga kababayan po. At let us spare po yung uniform personnel sa mga ganito pong mga usaping political po.
Meanwhile, his colleagues at the House of Representatives lashed out at Alvarez. Surigao del Sur Representative Johnny Pimentel said the remarks made by Alvarez are uncalled for and is tantamount to an act of sedition or rebellion. Lanao del Norte Representative Khalid Dimaporo warned Alvarez could face an ethics panel probe on his recent statements against Marcos Jr. Camiguin Representative Jordine Jesus Romualdo, for his part, called on the Justice Department to investigate the former speaker for what he described as seditious statements and to file the necessary charges. The PNP, for its part, said its legal officers will look into whether Alvarez's statement could be considered seditious.
Well, pag-aaralan po natin yan ng ating mga legal officers po and other concerned units po if those statement may be considered as a seditious statement. But for now po, ay hindi po tayo muna hantong sa mga ganyang usapin po. Dahil sabi po nga ay we will see. We will monitor po kung ano pong magiging sitwasyon po in terms of peace and security.
Bianca Dava, ABS-CBN News.